this show, I'm always hunting for big picture themes that can help you try to make money for years and years, not days and days or quarters and quarters. Investment ideas that give you something to fall back on when the market inevitably gets hammered and benefit when it goes higher. That's why tonight I'm helping you put together a shopping list based on these trends. Trends that work regardless of whether the U.S. economy is going strong or going slow, or Ben Bernanke tightens this, currency goes that way. So far we've got agriculture, we've got energy savers, and now I have to mention a theme that, frankly, I wish I didn't have to mention at all. I wish it didn't exist at all. Homeland security. But like it or not, the story's not going away. When you think of the military-industrial complex, when you think of lavish federal defense contracts, please don't imagine fighter jets or submarines or tanks. That's not where the opportunity is anymore. The new theme in security is prevention and protection, regardless of what part controls Congress or that White House. The Republicans don't want to slash this kind of spending. The Democrats can't afford to, or they'll be panning this week on defense. We still mourn the day that Jack Bauer in 24 went off the air. The show may be gone, unless you're watching on DVD or Netflix, but the fight against terrorism is still here. As long as we have a terrorism problem, as long as countries around the world are spending $140 billion fighting it, a figure that should double over the next decade, according to the British Trade and Information Office, we might as well try to make some money off this enormous defense theme. Now, there are many different ways to play a big theme like security, stocks that I think would be worth getting some exposure to on a pullback. However, many of these counterterrorism stocks are extremely speculative. I'm going to say it again, extremely speculative. This is a terrific place to look for ideas, but you need to be very discriminating when you pick individual stocks, especially since many of these stocks have a tendency to run up enormously before, on occasion, getting smacked down. You've got straight-up physical security plays. Which one are we thinking about? American Science and Engineering, ASEI. They make X-ray scanners that detect weapons like explosives. Hold that trigger finger. I don't want you buying ASEI until it goes lower. The name of the game here is patience. I'm giving you a list of Homeland Security stocks so you can go and do your own homework on them. And only buy when we get a decent pullback and a good entry point. I say that constantly on Twitter at Jim Cramer. Please do the homework. People blast me. They don't know what they own. Do the homework with that caveat in mind, though. ASEI is the pure play on X-ray machines, making vans with mobile scanners that are used in Afghanistan, as well as drive-through systems, and all of their tech is protected by a massive wall of patents. Then there are also cybersecurity stocks, a business that's growing dramatically as more and more sensitive information gets stored on the web and, of course, hacked. Take Fortinet, FTNT. That's a network security play that's made us a lot of money here on Mad Money. This company is the leading player in what's known as the unified threat management business. It makes one platform that gives customers the whole network security package, everything from antivirus, firewall, anti-spam, to traffic optimization and data loss prevention, one that ultimately costs less than cobbling together separate security offerings from a host of different vendors. I say proceed with extreme caution, but definitely worth keeping an eye on and putting on the security shopping list. How about Verint, VRNT, which makes software that's used by security companies, law enforcement, and intelligence agencies to analyze video and communications data? Again, though, do not pay up for these stocks. If you're patient, a market-wide sell-off could bring them down to prices that are very attractive long-term. But you will not make money here if you chase these security stocks and pay up for them. I'm only mentioning these stocks because I trust you to be responsible with them. Remember, security is an uber long-term theme. There's no reason to hurry. To capture both sides of the security space, both physical security and network security, maybe you need to play nice. As in NICE Systems. This is an Israeli company that makes high-quality analytics software for video surveillance that can spot things like unattended bags or intruders. They also do traditional cloak-and-dagger spy stuff, like communications interception. And on the other hand, NICE has a much more quotidian voice-logging business that helps companies manage financial risk and comply with regulations. I want you to think of NICE as a security twofer that's less speculative than the rest. Here's the bottom line. The need to secure our people against terrorists and our data against all kinds of online predators is not going away anytime soon. And that makes counterterrorism and network security two big businesses. It's a long-term theme to fall back on and circle the wagons around when the market gets hammered. But please, 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 don't try to chase these security stocks when the averages are roaring, because you know what will happen? As great as they are, you will only get hurt. Stay with Cramer.